friends, welcome back to my channel. I'm filming with the Sigma and Beauty and the Beast collection. I told you guys that no matter what time of the day it was, I was gonna sit and film with it, and it's here. So yeah, I'm so excited to dive into it. If you guys are new to my channel, welcome. My name is Karen Harris. I like to film tan girl friendly makeup videos here on YouTube. I do post quite often, pretty much every day. So if you are not subscribed, highly recommend doing so. Turn on that bell so you're notified every time I post. And without further blabbering, let's get into it. Okay, so I feel like Alice in Wonderland has just had her heyday with all of the collabs, all of the palettes, and I've just been patiently waiting for somebody to do a Beauty and the Beast collection. And the way I just like gasped when I saw Trend Mood post that Sigma was collabing with Beauty and the Beast, I was so excited. So I got a notification that a package was heading my way, and I was like, I think this is it. I think it's the Sigma palette. So it's here. Let's go ahead and grab it. It's really big, so brace yourself. I tried to do close-ups, so I will insert them as I go along, but how cute. Should I just make this my background for the video? I'll just attach it to my head and I'll be like, hey guys. Just kidding, but how gorgeous. I think this is my favorite Disney box that they've done. I have my Cinderella box still. I have my Alice box. You're gonna have to pull those out of my cold dead hands, but let's go ahead and dive into it. I don't know if you can buy this full collection. You probably can, knowing Sigma, but look at this. Look at this. Isn't it beautiful? There's a beautiful model dressed as their version of Belle, and they have the font there. It's so gorgeous. And then we have everything right here. Now I have most of my makeup done because I did film earlier today and I wiped off most of my makeup and retouched up so we could film. So let's start off with the bag. It's super duper cute. I do have the other bags as well from the other collection. It just has like this beautiful dark blue glitter, and the glitter does not come off, so you can store your whole collection in here, or you can just put your brush set in the palette. It has just like the best detail. There's a little emblem of Belle on the zipper here, so super duper cute. We have a brush set with this collection, so the entire set retails for $89. It's $135 value. The first brush is the F46, and they have a very famous foundation brush called the F80. I love that one for foundation, but I love this angle as well. So it says it's for applying and blending liquid or cream foundations. I think it would be perfect for that. Also great for just like setting the under eye a little bit, or if you like a cream blush or a cream highlighter. I love using brushes like this just to kind of stamp it on the cheeks. So that is the F46. Next is one of my favorite brushes. This is the F44. I actually have one that I've been using quite a bit. So this brush is good for sculpting with powder products. So I like to use it for bronzer, and it's just like perfect. It really hugs my cheeks and my cheekbones, and I love going around the parameters of my face with this. So as you can see, it's a little bit more scrunched up, but with time it does loosen up, and it almost looks like a very dense fan brush. It has a great shape. So yeah, that is the F44. So next we have eyeshadow brushes. This is the E24. Sigma has a similar brush called the E25, which is just a little bit bigger. This is the 24, so it's the diffuse blend brush, and this is just great for blending. You can also really pack on eyeshadows with this. So I love the E25 and the E24. I have a ton of brushes with this shape in my collection. Next is the E15. Again, one that I see a lot throughout Sigma's brush bundles. This is a flat shader brush. Use this one again all the time for applying those really pigmented metallic eyeshadows on the lid. Last but certainly not least is the E15. This is their flat definer brush, and this is really great for that under eye work. Also, you can do a nice wing liner look with this if you're wanting to use eyeshadow. So it's just a really nice brush, great for carving out the brow bone, all kinds of stuff. So another great inclusion in the set. So the entire set, again, is $89, and it does come with the bag. So if you want to snag that cute bag and you want some great brushes, that might be a good piece to invest in. Next, we have 3 hydrating lip creams. So this is a newer-ish formula. Now, this formula was introduced, I believe, in the Alice collection. Don't quote me on that, but they have had this formula before. And then very recently, they actually launched a collection of lip creams in individual packaging for us to enjoy. I love those. They're basically a gloss and a cream lipstick hybrid. So they go on very shiny and opaque and beautiful. They're not like super long wearing like a liquid lipstick, but they do have some really good staying power and pigmentation. So we have 3 shades. I did swatch these. I definitely feel like my favorite shade is Adventure. I think I'm probably gonna wear this one. It's like a rosy brown nude shade, so I think that's gonna work really well with my skin tone. But I did swatch all 3 of these for you guys to see. Again, I cannot tell you how beautiful the attention to detail with this collection is, as all of their Disney collections. I really feel like these products are just like Disney for grown-ups. They are something where it would catch your eye and you'd be like, oh, is that like a Disney makeup item? But also it looks very elegant, so it doesn't look kitty, it looks more like grown up, and so you can still like represent your love for Disney but also have something for, you know, somebody that wants something a little less obvious, a little more subtle. But this is so beautiful. Again, I do have close-ups and swatches. This is the Disney Beauty and the Beast cheek palette, retailing for $39. It does have 2 gorgeous blushes and 1 highlight. The highlight looks amazing. I cannot wait to put it on my face. We have 1 matte blush called Something Sweet, and then the blush on the other side called Beauty Within seems to have more of a shimmery vibe to it. So it's gorgeous. And something I didn't do a very good job of capturing in my close-ups is this little plastic piece that they put on all the products. It has this beautiful stained glass detailing, and it just looks so cute because they made it kind of colorful and included the rose. So I think it looks amazing. Last but certainly not least, we have the gorgeous eyeshadow palette. So this retails for $59. It has 14 buttery soft eyeshadows and a dual-ended brush, which we all know and love. Now, I did swatch this palette, and let me tell you, it swatched really beautifully. I feel like I was expecting this palette to be a very neutral palette, but Sigma definitely hid some beautiful surprises in here. So there are some gorgeous neutral shades. There's a really cool shade called Winter's Night, which is a sheer white, shimmery, sparkly like eye topper. We also have the shade called Rose Petal, which is a duochrome like purple golden shade. The shade Beast is a gorgeous midnight blue. And then we have Enchantress, which is kind of like a grungy golden green shade. And then we have some purples like Mashir and Pots, which were more on the mauve spectrum. So a little bit more unexpected. I feel like in the pictures I saw, the palette definitely looked like it was more of a goldeny leaning palette, more like Lumiere, less like all the other characters. So I was thinking we were getting a neutral palette. I feel like they actually did give us some color to play with as well. So we have a bit of a half colorful, half neutral palette. Now, I did pull out my Alice in Wonderland palette as well as my Cinderella collaboration palette, so we will include comparisons in the end. But I just kind of wanted to go over the entire collection with you guys and just give you guys my thoughts as we were unboxing everything. I'm so pumped, so let's go ahead and put on a lip because I've been sitting here without any lipstick on and I really want to use this shade. It's called Adventure, and I just need something on my lips right now. So let's go ahead and pop that on. This is such a pretty color. I really like this color. This is my favorite color from the 3 lippies in the mini set. The other 2 seem very similar to me, and I feel like they would be more flattering on lighter skin tones, but I do really like this color. So I wish they had kind of made individual lip shades so you could just buy whatever shade you wanted, but just wanted to tell you guys which one was my favorite. And the other thing I love about these is they're so easy to apply. I know a lot of us are so busy and we don't have time to sit there when we're going about our day to pull out a lip liner and line our lips and things like that. And I'm definitely not a lip liner gal. I'm a mom of two. I got places to be, things to do. And I love being able to apply something without having a mirror in front of me and on the go. So I think this is the perfect formula for that. Okay, next, these cheeks definitely deserve some color. So there is a little bit of bronzer on. I'm gonna go ahead and play with the blushes. So since there are two blushes in this palette, I'm gonna use two different brushes. So the first one is from my collab set with Sigma Beauty. This is the F36, and I picked this one to be in my favorite set because it's basically like a hug on your face. It's so nice and dense, and you can just pat on the blush. So on this side, I'm doing something sweet. And it's a beautiful mauve-y blush. And I am building it up just a little bit so you guys can see that color on me. And I just really enjoy this brush for blush. You can also use it to powder all over your face. I know my friend Heather has really oily skin and she loves to use this as a powder brush to really press those powders in to her face. So here is the shade Something Sweet. That song is now playing on a loop in my head. Okay, then on this side we have Beauty Within. This is the more kind of shimmery blush and it has a beautiful rose embossed on it. And so I'm just gonna kind of put that on. I'm using the Sigma, I love this one for blush too. It is the F37. It's like a smaller brush. And hopefully you guys can see how beautiful and shimmery this one is. So I love that they included two different formulas. I have a shimmery blush like this in my Sigma favorite set. It's the shade Tiger Lily. I actually put it on for the video I filmed earlier today. So it's funny that this set has two blushes because I believe in the Cinderella collection and the Alice collection, we've only had a duo. So we've had a matte blush and a highlighter. So I love that they threw in this more shimmery blush as well if you are into a more shimmery look, or you can mix them for sure. So that's the matte side. This is the shimmery side. This is so stunning. I love it so, so much. Now wait until you guys see the highlighter. I'm excited to put it on because it's swatched so beautifully. It's so creamy. Okay, so I'm just grabbing this Real Techniques brush and I love it. They call the highlighter Lumiere. Totally makes sense. Look at it. It's so beautiful. It has like a sheer base, but it's so sparkly. I hope my camera is picking it up. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. You guys, I have to tell you a fun fact. I cannot sing to save my life, right? But I've told you guys before that Beauty and the Beast was actually my high school musical, which it's the only Disney movie I really know, like, very well. Because some people know Disney, like, the back of their hand. They know all the references. I am not that person. Didn't really grow up with it. But I have a special place in my heart for Beauty and the Beast. Because we did that show multiple days over multiple weekends. So, yeah, I really, really enjoyed it. Anyway, can sing. Kind of can dance. So I auditioned. And listen, I was very shy, okay? I wasn't in the choir or anything, but I was like, let me put myself out there. And I definitely auditioned for Lumiere. I did not get the part, but I feel like me and Lumiere are kind of like soulmates because he has a very like chill personality and he's kind of like a troublemaker. So I really thought that that part was like made for me. I didn't get the part. I was a champagne glass in the song Be Our Guest, and yeah, it just brings back such fun memories of me in like 10th grade. So anyway, that's a fun little story for you guys. But highlighter's on, blush is on, lip cream is on, everything is looking on point. So let's go ahead and play with this eyeshadow palette. There is a mini eyeshadow palette in this collection as well. Sigma did not send that to me, but basically what they do is they take 7 of the shades in the bigger palette and they turn it into a smaller palette. So I have here my Corta Rosa palette. This I included in my Sigma favorite set. Listen, I'm gonna pimp out my Sigma favorite set. If you guys haven't bought it yet, what are you doing? Support a girl out. Anyway, so this is what the mini palette will look like. And it has seven of their, I guess, favorite shades from the big palette. So from the card they included in this collection, it looks like they included Bookworm, Forbidden, Belle, Enchantress, Beast, Be Our Guest, and Cogsworth. And they did include some really fun shades, like Enchantress and Beast really stood out to me when I was swatching it. So if you don't want this giant palette, you could definitely get the mini palette, and that one is going to retail for $32 as well. So I do have this little card. This whole collection is launching on October 17th, so not too long from now. And if I didn't say it already, I am a Sigma Beauty affiliate, a very proud Sigma Beauty affiliate. They are actually based in the Midwest, which doesn't happen very often for makeup brands, and they're one state away from me. So they are in Minnesota, and if you are new to my channel, because I do have some newer subscribers, I actually got to visit them 2 summers ago, which is just wild. Like, I got to visit Sigma HQ, meet the owner, meet their PR people, and it was just such a wild experience because I'm just like a nobody over here, and to be included in something like that was just out of this world. So I'm always appreciative to Sigma for that. That does not mean that I'm gonna tell you that something is really good if it's crappy, okay? I'm gonna tell you it's crappy, but I do have a special place in my heart for this brand because they really just took a chance on me, just like a lot of other brands that I have had the pleasure of working with. Anyways, sorry to go on a little trip down memory lane, but I can't help it, okay? I'm really excited about this collection. Like I said, it has a very special place in my heart just because it was my high school thing. Like, I have such fond memories of it. Okay, enough about that. Let's go ahead and put this eyeshadow palette on my face. I'm so excited. I don't know if I'm gonna do one look or two looks. What I'm gonna do, I think I should do two looks just so we can see like what we can achieve with this palette. I feel like I have to do a neutral look for the neutral girlies, and I feel like I have to use the shade Beast because it just is like the most beautiful midnight blue shade, so it deserves its own moment. And then on the dual ended brush, they have another two favorite brushes of mine. We have the E38, which is the diffuse crease brush, and the E54, which is the medium sweeper, also a great brush for packing on eyeshadow. So let's go ahead and start off with the neutral look since we gotta do it for the neutral galleys out there. I'm gonna start off with the shade Forbidden, which is that dark brown shade. You guys, I mean, come on, you know I'm gonna use the dark brown because your girl loves a smoky eye, okay? So we're just gonna plop that right there, and I'm just gonna pounce. Also, I'm feeling extra sassy because both my kids are sick. I might be a little delirious, but you know what? My husband came home after running an errand, and I was like, can you watch the kids so I can film? And he was like, yes. And I was like, okay, thank you. Usually he manages bath time, so very, very grateful for that. But that was perfection. It's opaque. I barely did any blending because I'm just placing the shadows right now. And next I'm going to use, listen, this is like my favorite shade ever, Runway. I love a good terracotta brown in the crease. I remember back in the day, I had the hardest time finding a shade like that for me. And I just feel like it's the perfect neutral crease color for my skin tone, and then it just started coming out of the woodwork. Like, every brand that did a neutral palette included a shade like that, and I was like, yes, we're in business, finally. Somebody made a brown shade that's tan girl friendly. So I am very, very happy to see that included in this palette as well. So just easy peasy, two shadows in the crease. Now we're gonna throw on a lid shade. I have so many options. I feel like I need to go with Little Town. It's taking me everything to not burst into song as I play with this collection. I'm actually doing you guys a favor though, because if you hear me sing, you might never watch my channel again. Okay, so we're gonna put Little Town right here, and we're gonna bring it in almost all the way, but we're gonna stop because of course we have to use some other metallic shades as well. But look at that pigmentation. Look at how bright and beautiful this shade is. And I feel like Sigma always nails their timing because this is just gonna be the makeup gift for a Beauty and the Beast lover. I can already hear people screaming that love this movie, that were maybe a part of this musical, like I was in high school. But look at that, it's so beautiful. Okay, so I'm gonna take the shade Be Our Guest and put that on the inner portion of the eyelid that I kind of left without a metallic, just to kind of create some depth there. I like to throw in a lighter shade on the inner corner just to keep things interesting and create dimension. And I'm gonna probably use that as my inner corner as well. Okay, so that side is basically done. Now we're gonna focus on this eye and let's see what I can come up with. I kinda wanna do something a little bit fun and dramatic. So I'm gonna go in with this definer brush and I'm gonna go into the shade Beast and we're gonna try and create a wing. Look at that, that was so easy. That was so easy. And then I'm just gonna drag it onto the lid. Such a beautiful pigmented color. And I'm just running that along the lash line. Oh my gosh, I really like how that turned out. That was way quicker than I thought. I definitely need to do this more instead of being scared. I'm always like such a creature of habit when it comes to eye looks. I'm like, oh my gosh, I don't know if I can do that. So I do kind of the same look every time, but we're gonna get experimental over here, okay? So now I'm gonna go into Winter's Night, which is that really pretty shade that I told you guys about, which is like a sheer base. And I feel like I just wanna like tuck that onto the lid. Oh my God, that looks so beautiful. And I did use my Sigma Ignite eyeshadow primer. So that's like a beautiful base for this. And I'm just tucking the shimmer a little bit into the crease as well. And I kind of want to just, you know, leave it like that. Like I feel like I could just leave it like that, but I really want to tuck a little bit of the shade called Enchantress into the very outer edge here and kind of like bring it down a little bit. So different for me. I never do stuff like this. Okay, I'm going to take a little bit of Cogsworth on the E24 and I'm just going to run that on the edge here. Just to give that definition a little bit on the crease. But yeah, I'm just going to keep it like easy and simple. Do something in the waterline and the lower lash line and I will be right back to give you guys my thoughts on this collection and yeah, just chit chat about it and see how we feel. Okay friends, so here are the two finished looks with the new Sigma and Beauty and the Beast eyeshadow palette. Definitely let me know if you have one that you like more down in the comments. You can leave a neutral heart like the brown one or the like white one that they have, or if you like this one, definitely leave me a blue heart emoji. Let me know, vote for your favorite. It always is so fun to see which look you guys prefer. Also, just know that I definitely went outside my comfort zone for this look, so be nice. Okay, be nice. I was just trying something different. Anyways, let's go ahead and look at the Beauty and the Beast palette against the other Disney collab palettes they've done. So let's start off with the oldest sister of the bunch. We have the Cinderella palette. And yes, I kept the plastic packaging. I don't do that all the time, but I can't help it with these ones. I do feel like I need to keep them. So this is the Cinderella palette. And it's so fun to see things like this side by side now because you really see how much more blue was included in the Cinderella. So here is it next to the Beauty and the Beast palette in case you're like, Karen, do I actually need both of these? I mean, I don't know. You're a grown up, so you get to decide, but here they are. Of course, to me, the neutral shades are gonna be probably similar. I won't say they're exact dupes because I haven't swatched them all next to each other, but if you have the Cinderella, I feel like you can get away with getting the Beauty and the Beast one. And then, of course, I do have the beautiful Alice in Wonderland palette. This one is definitely a little bit more colorful. It's got a lot of blues and greens and golden yellow tones. So hopefully seeing these side by side is helpful. I feel like I'm biased. You guys already know I absolutely love Beauty and the Beast, so to me, if Sigma hadn't sent me this collection, I would have bought everything. I would have bought every little stinking piece. I mean, look at me. I literally have a Belle hairbrush sitting in my makeup studio. Don't look at the hair. Okay, but it is one of those franchises that I actually love a whole lot. Anyways, now that you've seen the comparisons, let's go ahead and dissect all the pieces to this collection so I can tell you what I think is worth the splurge and what you can skip on. So let's start off with the brush set. I feel like brush sets are just so universal. You know, it's not a color product. Whether you prefer neutral shades or really colorful eyeshadow palettes, a brush set is always a solid staple. These Sigma brushes are really well made. They do have a 2-year guarantee, and these ones are special, so they have this gorgeous midnight blue handle, and each of the brushes has a little kind of emblem or imprint on them. So this one has Lumiere, this one has the Beast on it, Belle is on the bronzer brush, and then we have, who's on here, Cogsworth on the flat shader. So each of them are customized with the characters on there. The bag is absolutely stunning. So if you want something that isn't a color product, this might be your best bet. Also, I just opened it and it's so beautiful. It has this beautiful yellow lining on the bag, and it's got a yellow rose print in there with like the castle as well as Belle and Beast in their dance scene. So it's so cute. That was kind of a surprise. I did not know that was in there. I just opened the bag to put the brushes in. So that is the brush set. The lip set, I will say, is one of those things that I would only buy if you like all three of these shades. I really, really like the one shade in here, but I don't know that these two shades I would wear a ton. So that's why I wish they had come as like individual products so you could grab one. Although, if you want to, you can always get the set and split it with your friends or something like that. But to me, the lip set is not a must-have. You could just purchase one of the Sigma lip creams individually and try out the formula if that's what you're into. Next, we have the face palette. I love that they didn't do a duo this time. I love that they did a trio, and this highlighter is beautiful. I think this will work even on a deeper skin tone because it's very pigmented, and I think you can layer it. Same with the blushes, depending on where you place them, you might be able to make them work on a little bit of a deeper skin tone. I'm not really sure how deep though. I have more of like a medium tan complexion. So yeah, absolutely stunning. I'm just so happy that it's not just a matte blush and a highlighter, and I love the shades they picked out. Just the other day, I used the Alice Duo, and I was just so happy that they didn't do another mauve blush. I really love the shades they chose for the Beauty and the Beast trio. And so I think that if you don't want the eyeshadow palette, this might be a fun way to kind of have a little palette from the collection with a absolutely beautiful highlighter and blushes. I think Sigma has amazing quality, so there's no fear for me with recommending that. And then, of course, the favorite thing for me is always eyeshadow. I will always pick eyeshadow as my favorite. So this is the eyeshadow palette again. Super cool. I am so invested in this color story. I really, really love the shade Beast. I think that is just such a fun little navy blue that is almost a black, but not really. Like, I love that because Sigma doesn't really do stuff like that. So I'm really excited. I cannot wait to dive into this like purple section right here. So I kind of want to do more looks with this palette. I don't know that I will have the time to get more looks up before the launch, but I think this is the same great Sigma quality that I'm used to. I know their eyeshadow formula isn't for everyone. I always tell the story. I tried them back in the day, back when I was a nobody, just getting into makeup. They had a store at the Mall of America, and I still remember this so well. I went into the Sigma store with my friend, and I picked one of their palettes. It was on sale. I saw the palette at Sigma HQ, it's still there. And I told the owner this story, and I was like, I hated that palette. I was so upset because the quality was so crappy. They changed it, and the next time I tried it, when I bought the Quarter Rosa palette with my own money, I was so blown away, and I'm so happy that they are a Midwest brand, a woman-owned indie brand that is just such a huge company. It is such a cool thing. Anyway, all that aside, the eyeshadow palette is beautiful. I love it. I think this is a great piece if you are a Disney fan. Even if you're not a Disney fan, if you're looking at Sigma's current eyeshadow palette offering, I think this is a solid winner because it has some really pretty neutrals, some pretty purples, some unexpected shades. Might be a fun one to pick up if you are a Sigma fan. So before I sign off, I just want to remind you again, this collection launches on October 17th. They did have a bit of a leak. I think I saw it was on like JCPenney and stuff. So I don't know if you could have purchased it on the JCPenney website, but I know it's going to be on Sigma's website on the 17th. I did receive this collection in PR with no obligation to post. I do have an affiliate code with them. It's KHMakeup10, and that'll save you some money on the Sigma website. And I will also make a small commission. So I just want to let you guys know. That is it, you guys. I'm done. I'm done. I'm done talking about this for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did. It's a free way to support my channel. And I will see you guys in another video very, very soon. Bye!